Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll be studying about the LTE introduction. Remember, we have studied WCDMA and CDMA technologies in which wideband spectrum was available for transmitting the user information. Since the applications have increased and the demand for these applications have increased, still higher bands are required for transmission of this data. Hence, 3GPP LTE or a long-term evolution promises extremely high data rates up to 1 Gbps. In this lecture, we will be studying the introduction of the 3GPP or the LTE, that is the long-term evolution. In 2004, when there was a rollout for the wideband code division multiple access or WCDMA, the 3GPP industry had already started to work on the fourth generation systems. It was predicted at that time that the data rates and the spectral efficiency of the WCDMA would not meet the demands of the future applications, and hence a new system had to be developed. And it was decided to completely change both the air interface and the core networks of the system. The air interface then moved on to the OFDM, which is orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, as a modulation technique, and orthogonal frequency division multiple access as an accessing technique. Multiple access is where multiple users are able to access the same system. The core network was to evolve into a pure packet switch network. This new standards became as 3GPP long-term evolution, or simply known as LTE. This development of LTE originally took place in parallel to the evolution of WCDMA. The release 8 of LTE gave the data rates up to 300 Mbps, and release 10 of LTE, which is known as LTE Advanced, gave data rates up to 1 Gbps. Let us see what were the goals of this LTE systems. LTE aims to achieve a peak data rate of 100 Mbps in downlink and 50 Mbps in uplink direction. It is always expected that the user is going to download more amount of data than it is going to uplink. A 20 MHz spectrum has been allocated for each user in downlink as well as in uplink. Thus, the required spectral efficiency is 5 and 2.5 bits per second per hertz for the downlink and uplink. Due to the wide range of application and the required data rate, LTE defines a number of different types of mobile stations that are present. They present a trade-off between the complexity and the performance. These various classes of mobile stations are as follows. They vary in the range of peak data rate in downlink direction that is available, say 10, 50, 100, 150 or 300 Mbps. They also vary in the uplink direction for data rates from 5, 25, 50 to 75 Mbps. Also, they vary in the uplink as well as in the downlink modulation formats. Other goals of this LTE are control plane latency, which is defined as the time for a handset to transition from various non-active states to active state. This is basically between 50 or 100 milliseconds. Furthermore, at least 400 active mobile cells should be supported in a single cell. And the last goal is the user plane latency. It is defined as the time it takes to transmit a small internet protocol packet to the edge of the radio access network, or RAN. This should not exceed 5 milliseconds in a network with a single mobile station. That means there should be no problem of the congestion. So this was a basic introduction on the LTE. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.